then, you know...
So I'm going to repeat my question, but be more specific. What criteria do you use to decide that a hadith is authentic Islam and a hadith isn't?
Like I've just said. If it's like Aisha narrates...
What about if Muhammad narrates? If Mahmoud narrates? Yes. What is the difference between Mahmoud and Aisha narrate?
What is the difference between?
Mahmoud and Aisha narrate.
I don't know, you tell me.
You just ask your question.
Yes.
How can you differentiate between an authentic hadith and an unauthentic hadith?
Yes.
You said if Aisha narrates,
yes.
What does it make it?
Then for me, I would say that the chances are that is more authentic than...
If Aisha narrated it?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So what about... But there's no criteria, man. Because why? Between Aisha and you, there is another narrator.
So what would... So now I'm interested now. You've got my interest.
Yeah.
So now, what would you use to say this is authentic?
No, okay. Before we start speaking about what is authentic or is not, you're not Muslim to begin with. So it's like you and I speaking about which curtain should we put in the house. We haven't even agreed there is a house to begin with. Let us establish there is a house, then let us speak about the curtain after. Make sense?
Let me just ask you this and then we do.
No, before you ask
that's
me,
okay.
Before I ask you a question, does it make sense?
Yeah, no, it makes sense.
That's what I'm saying. So imagine you and I, we're speaking about... I'll give you an example. Imagine you and I, we want to establish a university.
Yes.
And we haven't even established university yet, and we are speaking about where the bathroom is going to be. That one says upstairs.
Yes.
Let's establish a university first, and get the money first, and then start talking about the bathroom.
Okay, so how do you
do it? Now, hear me out. That's how I do it. First, we talk about the foundation. You are a Christian, correct?
No, I'm not a Christian.
Okay, where are you?
I'm a Nazarene.
Of course, Nazarene means a follower of Jesus.
Right.
Correct.
Okay. Seen the Quran.
Yeah, of course, that's true. That's the correct name for it, yeah?
Thank you.
Sahih. So now you are a follower of Jesus.
That's right.
Okay, so you believe, because I want to know about you, too, for me to start speaking to you. Do you accept Jesus as God?
Yes.
Okay. You and I, we believe in there is God.
Yes.
And we believe God is perfect, correct?
Yes.
Okay. As a Muslim, Allah told me that Jesus cannot be God.
Okay.
Okay?
Now, I know this about Islam.
Okay, okay. Now I'm going to give you a logical argument. You and I, we can share that we can establish Jesus.
I thought we were talking about Islam and rather than talking
We talk about the foundation, I said.
Yes, so can we talk about the foundations of Islam?
Doesn't make any sense because...
I'll give you an example. Really.
If you want to pour water in a dirty cup, what would you do first?
I'd clean.
That's it, we have to clean first the dirt, then we put the water. So let us go back to the foundation. Do you understand that?
Yes.
So now, you and I, we know God knows everything all the times, correct?
Well, I believe it. I don't know it, but yes, I believe.
Okay, as a Muslim, when I say I believe, mean I know and I'm certain. But in English term, that's why it's dangerous. So, do you believe God knows everything all the time?
Yes.
It says in the Bible, in your Bible, it says God knows everything.
Yes, God knows everything, but then can God make a stick that, you know, it's again that thing, isn't it? Can God make a stick?
No, I'm not talking about contradiction thing. I'm talking about God knows everything. I'm not talking about a stick. Look, let me give you a logical argument that God knows everything.
Yeah,
okay, in order for you to create an iPhone, you have to know the knowledge how to create an iPhone.
That's clear.
So therefore, no one knows about the iPhone in details, bit by bit, slide by slide, except who? The one who made it. So therefore, no one knows about the creation in details except the one who made it.
True.
So therefore, the creator knows everything about his creation.
Yeah, but the iPhone is not everything.
No, but I'm just giving you example.
My example.
Okay, yeah, so but more so who God could, would know everything about
because
everything.
He created everything.
More so.
Maybe I'm misunderstanding. Maybe I'm not comprehending what you're saying.
Look, I'm going to make it just to make it simple. I'm saying the creator knows everything about his creation. Do you accept that?
The creation, yes.
Everything about
creation. But the creation, I don't believe the creation is everything. If God might have created something before, he might create something later.
Creator knows everything. The creation knows.
You know what I'm saying? So,
okay.
Period.
Yeah. Let us stick to creation. Okay. Yes, of course, we know creator knows everything.
Okay.
So
that's now diminishing from everything.
Is there anyone, is there anyone more knowledgeable than the creator?
No, absolutely.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. So if Jesus is God, therefore no one should be more knowledgeable than him.
I agree.
You agree, that's good.
Yes.
But only if you go to Mark 13:32, Jesus said no one knows the day and the hour. Not even the angels in the heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father.
Yes.
So according to Jesus' word in alayhi salatu wasalam, which goes in line with Allah's statement in the Quran, Allah says, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ أَيَّانَ مُرْسَاهَا. They ask about the hour. when we'll be established, say no one knows except Allah.
Yes.
So from the Bible, Mark 13:32, clearly that there is someone has more knowledge than Jesus.
Yes.
Therefore, Jesus cannot be God.
Okay. I personally,
yeah,
what I say to you,
yeah,
is I think that point is a valid point.
Yeah.
But then I think there are also valid points on the other side. So what
which
I
is?
Wait.
Yeah, I'm waiting.
Wait.
Which is?
Like you say, we have to clean the cup first.
That's it. I agree with you. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Especially when there's a liars.
So what I'm saying to you,
yes,
is, I could be. No, that's not a valid point. No, listen.
I hope, sorry. I hope you're going to record me. Don't record me until you take back your lie. That you lie against Prophet Muhammad on a video. There's a hadith you are promoting, which is an authentic hadith. Will you take it back? The video that of that Christian boy. No, Christian boy, with no respect for that dirty guy. He speaks about Prophet. Yeah. Princess.
Yeah,
that hadith is authentic. So when you, in the video I made, I said, you know, soccer film, this hadith is unauthentic. And the guy is telling me clearly, fake Muslim, you know.
Yeah.
I never see this Muslim become Christian in real life. I never see that. Anyway, the point he say, because of this hadith, you should leave Islam. So please, this hadith is unauthentic. So tell him to come back to Islam.
Right.
Good.
Yeah, I would love to see you debate Christian.
Come back. I'll ask you. No, hear me out. Hear me out. Do you know me to debate?
Hear me out.
Do you know me to debate online?
Why?
Do you know me to debate online?
Advice. Don't.
No. I'm not asking you. Tell me your life story. Do you, no,
I support
you for answering.
I
want a Christian to ask you a question. Do you know me to debate online? Bro, I'm speaking to you. Don't advise me because I will dare him to come here.
Exactly.
Bring him here. I will give you money. Bring him here.
You'll give me money.
No, bring him here.
Yeah. Yeah.
I will embarrass him just as embarrass who? I embarrass Nabi Quraishi. Video. I embarrass him. You know what this guy does?
Everybody.
Behind the camera, using Google question answer. Speak to him. Bro, I'm a real man. Everyone knows me. Shabab Bush, I'm everywhere. This is a fake man behind the camera. On the camera, I'm here. Alhamdulillah. Go on.
Thank you.
Yes, liar. He lied. Go on.
Bye-bye.
Fake Muslims. Bye-bye. Fake Muslims.
Bye-bye.
Fake Muslims, bye-bye, fake Muslims.
Bye-bye,
fake Muslims.
Good. I learned not to bait him.
Who? Do you know him?
Pardon?
Do you know him?
No, but okay. I many years ago, before all these, most probably anybody who knew Christian Prince, I was looking at
him. Okay, do you know him?
And
No. Do you know him?
Wait.
This guy's...
Wait. So you Muslims have the ones that like you are educated not to debate him.
No. I know. I'm not a fake man. That I'm in a balcony.
Don't
back
debate
in the day,
him,
bro. Can I speak? Is a real man someone who's a balcony inside the balcony telling the guys outside? Why are you scared?
Yeah.
The words of the balcony should come outside, innit?
Yeah.
I'm here, alhamdulillah, every
is
day.
Is that all you're saying? Is that because he's
bro? I'm here. Yeah. No. Forget about computer. I'm here. You want to come to me here?
That's right.
Alhamdulillah. Do you know Nabi Qureshi?
Yeah.
Okay, Nabi Qureshi, they used to say, Shamsi, you Muslims scared of Nabi Qureshi. Nabi Qureshi destroyed Islam. Guess what? He came here, speechless. No debate him, I expose him, bi'idhnillah. I'm exposing you now, you have no clue to say.
Same with David Wood as well. David Wood came here, got exposed.
Speechless, alhamdulillah.
Okay.
Do you know what it's called?
Okay.
Do you know what it's called?
Right. Okay.
The cage of a lion.
Okay, alright, great. Listen.
The lion's cage.
Wow, listen.
You know what I'm saying?
Listen.
These are the cats.
Listen.
The cats are online.
Okay, alright, okay. Alright. So, okay, I'm going to swallow. Right?
Don't swallow, just talk about your Bible.
No.
You can't swallow anymore.
Listen. I know the things you're going to say. I've done it in the 90s, I've done it in the 2000s.
About the one of God.
I've also listened to you. By the way, I do have some respect for you. I think you're pretty good at what you do.
Give me some money then.
But in the end of the day, yes.
Have you watched my videos?
No, I'm just speaking. Go on,
good.
But I do honestly want to talk about the hadith. So what I'm going to
do... No. Doesn't make any sense. Christians speak about hadith.
Yes.
Bro, no. Why do you want to speak about God? You believe is God. He does not know everything.
This is... Okay, so...
What's your name?
I will swallow.
What's your name? Sorry.
My name's Eddie.
Eddie, Shamsi.
Eddie,
what I'm saying to you...
Yes.
Adin.
Eddin, yes.
Adin, okay.
Yes.
Adin.
I would like to have... Because for me, I like to know about the hadith. I like to know about certain things.
Adin, I can see you're honest, man. Let me ask you.
So if you know something I don't know, I want to have that discussion.
Adin, I want to ask you something. Adin, you are a person of logic, correct?
Definitely.
Imagine Hitler comes to you. He said, don't follow Stalin because he's a murderer.
Yes.
He's a killer.
Yes.
You should follow me.
Yes.
Do you think that is a correct statement to say for Hitler? Is it, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah,
you are, because you are here to defend a Christian boy.
I used to see
so that's what I'm saying. So Christian boy saying to the so-called Muslim, yeah, you should leave Islam because Prophet Muhammad what? Is an evil man.
I'm not.
Hey, I'm not talking about you. Yeah, I'm talking about the guy you defended.
Okay.
Please, I don't want to speak to hyena. I speak to human beings. Okay. What Prophet Muhammad said. So he's an evil man, correct? So therefore. I'm speaking to you, I have respect. Adin, I'm saying, logic dictates. Brother, Habibi, I listen to you. I'm saying, look, if you say to some Ikhwa, my brothers, I always advise my brothers, let me speak to hear my point. To hear my point, barakallahu fikum. Adin, hopefully you are a man of intellect and dignity. Okay? Inshallah. And I hope so. I'm saying, if you're telling a Muslim to leave Islam, because Prophet Muhammad was an evil man, he fought against enemies.
I haven't said that.
No, I'm not saying you. I'm saying if someone's saying that. On the other hand, you believe your God, say burn your daughter alive. Is it a good thing or an evil thing? You believe the same thing. You, Jesus as a God, he was telling you to kill babies. So is that okay? That's what I'm saying. That's called what? Hypocrisy. Adin.
But I'm not a hypocrite.
No, I'm not saying, of course you, Adin, not.
Yes.
Okay? Yeah. I'm saying about you defending someone, telling me don't debate him, tell him to come here, and today, tell him, listen, because he keeps talking, I want to see his face. Put niqab and come. Yeah. Just come to real life. You know what I mean? I'm not known to debate online. I'm not known to debate in stages.
Yeah.
I'm not known. Well, I'm here, alhamdulillah. I'm here all giving da'wah outside the police station. I'm here in Birmingham. I'm everywhere. Everyone knows me. No Shamsuddin, alhamdulillah. I'm not behind the camera. You know what it's called? Jihadi keyboards, he called. He's behind like the script and he's reading. So what I'm saying, that I will speak today. Hyena, I don't do with hyena.
I do
with human beings. He's a human being. Okay. So my point here is, Adin, reflect about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you could do Nazarenes. You know, we are true followers, or the true name of the true followers of Jesus. So what I'm saying, the Nazarenes, if you study about them, they never accept Jesus as God. وقالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. The Nazarenes claim that those who came after, not the true followers of Jesus, not the true Nazarenes, that Jesus is the son of Allah, or Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a powerful argument to show you that Jesus cannot be God. Do you know what the argument is, Adil? Do you know what his argument? Allah said, كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Both of them used to eat food. Do you know what it means? Both of them can be God. Because they live on food. So their life is based upon sustenance. You understand? So that's why I'm saying, Adin, think about it deeply and reflect upon it.
I have already thought about
that. So why stop you? Why stop you to become Muslim, Adin? Why stop you to become Muslim, Adin?
Because even if I found out that was wrong, I wouldn't become a Muslim.
Say it again.
Even if I found out that wasn't the way, I still wouldn't become Muslim. Now, I would take some things from Islam. Like, for instance, usury is not allowed.
A Christian destroyer. In a real life, not behind the cameras. Alhamdulillah. Come.
So I'll take fake. Some.
Nabi Qureshi, finish him, died. He couldn't take it, he died. He killed himself, I think. Alhamdulillah, can't speak, it's gonna speechless. Video is up, come to the real life.
I want to see that video, by the
way. Yeah, it's Nabi Shamsi, Nabi Qureshi.
Yeah.
You know, listen to me. I'm
but
not
David
here to be
Wood came and I didn't see him get destroyed.
Because he didn't speak to me, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, I'm not the best person to tell you, you know what I'm saying? Because
yeah.
I'm not a scholar. People say, and I'm not such a normal guy. Yeah. But alhamdulillah, what I deal with, foundation. I'm not going to let you tell me Prophet Muhammad had wives. No. Foundation. If the foundation is corrupted, therefore, what comes after is corrupted. Yeah. That you believe, they should to mock us. Is it logical to believe God was in a woman's vagina?
So let me ask you.
Yes. Is it logical to believe the Most High,
yes,
the all-powerful God,
yes,
he was in a woman's vagina?
No.
So you believe Jesus was God, though?
Yes, I do.
Was he in a woman's vagina?
Yes.
But I just told me no, doesn't make any sense.
Yeah. Oh. I agree with you, it doesn't make any sense.
So, alhamdulillah, Islam makes sense. According to Islam. Inna deen inda Allah al-Islam. Alhamdulillah.
Not Islam. Something
Adin, look out to yourself. I have to go. inshallah. But think about it, he was not, I saw you around, to be honest, but it's the first time I spoke to him. But think about it, it's not a joke.
But
it's
I would like to have another discussion with you on
about
the
hadith.
On the hadith.
Bro, good. Adin, logic dictates, establish there is a house before you put curtains.
I know. Okay. But could you at least please tell me one thing?
Go on.
What to you
hadith
makes authentic hadith?
Okay, my okay.
At least that.
Okay. Okay, the hadith sahih. ما يرويه العدل الضابط عن مثله.
The authentic hadith. What makes it sahih?
I'm giving you. Because I'm memorizing Arabic, the conditions. So that's why I'm gonna. So ما يرويه العدل الضابط عن مثله إلى منتهى من غير علة ولا شذوذ. That what the narrator narrates from a trustworthy, honest, truthful narrator, and all the narrators in the chain of narration, he has to be trustworthy, truthful, and they have to meet each other. Okay, without علة ولا شذوذ, without any hidden defection. Or go and Allah guess Allah. What is known by necessity.
Masha.
Okay, that's what the hadith says. Yeah. For example, Abu Bakr, for example, hadith that is narrated from Umar ibn Abdullah ibn Umar, from Nafi', from Imam Malik, from Shafi', from Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, this hadith without any doubt is sahih. Why? Imam Ahmad, what is his name? Abu Abdullah Ahmad ibn Hanbal al-Shaybani. Was he well known, well established to be trustworthy, truthful, honest person, person of piousness and righteousness? Imam al-Shafi'i, likewise, Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i, one known, well established to be trustworthy, truthful, and he was a teacher of Imam Ahmad. So they met each other. Imam Malik, Abu Abdullah, Malik ibn Anas, one known, established, trustworthy, truthful, honest man. Okay? Now who? Nafi'. Nafi' is what? The student of Abdullah ibn Umar. Abdullah ibn Umar ibn al-Khattab ibn al-Ardah, the student of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we can trace our deen is a living thing. We can trace it back. Hyena, what hyena? I'm in the jungle. Let's pick his corner.
I told you, don't mind. We're having a good discussion.
Please, Stella. He's a Nazarene, he's not Christians. Okay, so what I'm saying, so please.
Oh my God.
So what I'm saying, so that's the hadith. But what I will tell you, there is a book. There is a book.
Just go, please. Just go.
Just go. Just go.
Okay, there is a book. It's written this map. For example. Can I move? Can I move? Can I move?
Come.
I'm leave you alone. I'm married, man. After I'm married, I'm
Wallahi, if there's only woman I left in the world, I will not marry her. I will die single. Don't put that in the camera, brothers. I'm just. Hello, my wife, she sees it. Could be with a look, Shamsi, but the point, anyway. So there is many books written about hadith.
Now, that's what I was saying, but you said it much better than me.
Alhamdulillah.
And that's
not
why
because
I said, because it's such a long time since I've been. I would have said it, even I would still say I wouldn't have said it as well as you.
Yeah, but
I would
tell you,
have
Adin,
said it better than what I said.
Adin, one of their doubts, I'll tell you one of their doubts they tried. They tried to say your hadith, it was written 200 years after your Prophet Muhammad passed away.
So what would you say of Al-Tabari?
Al-Tabari, Muhammad ibn Mujahid al-Tabari, is one of the scholars of hadith, likewise scholars of tafsir and scholars of tariq. But one of them I want to mention, that they say to us, your hadith was written 200 years after. That is a lie of someone who's a crackhead. He's been crackhead for a long time. Okay, why? Because we have a narration that the Messenger of Allah وسلم, told to the Sahabi, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, write down the hadith. Okay? In the beginning, yes, the Messenger of Allah وسلم, wants to make sure that don't mix the Quran with any speech. Okay? So he said in the beginning, do not write down anything from me except the Quran. Okay? Afterwards, when they started with the Quran, he said, write on the hadith. Okay? Now there is Sahifa called Sahifa Humam ibn Munabbih. Who is Humam ibn Munabbih? He was a student of Abu Huraira. This Sahifa, which is called manuscript, is backdated the time of 2nd century or something, yeah? But it goes back to someone who lived at the time of Abu Huraira. So what does it say? Abu Huraira said, Prophet Muhammad said. You see what I'm saying? Like, look in the Bible says that there is. As much as many people take it in their hands to write an account, it seems good to me to write an account. Why? Because those who were eyewitnesses passed down narrations to me. So if the Christians reject hadith, then a big problem with
me. But it doesn't make sense in a sense of, if I say to you as a Nazarene, like Aisha narrated, that proves what you're saying. Aisha was not living in the same time as, say, Sahih Bukhari or Sahih Muslim, right?
He was not living
in the same time. Right. So if Sahih Bukhari says, or anyone who's writing hadith says, Aisha narrated, then that means...
No, don't say that.
No, wait.
If he says that, you know what it calls this hadith?
You know, even Bukhari says, Aisha said directly,
yes.
كل حديث معلق. You know what is معلق? معلق, in English translation, has been hanged. Meaning, there is no chain for it. So what we do, Bukhari is known, the sentence just summarizes, because it's trustworthy, okay? But as for the other narrators of hadith, we say, hold a minute, you have never reached Aisha. Okay?
I'm supporting your cause.
Yeah, of course, no, you have to. This happened at the time of the Salaf. Ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah ta'ala, Abdullah ibn Mubarak, one of the Muslim scholars, the early scholars, he was from the Salaf. A man came to him. He said, the Messenger of Allah said, he said, oh so and so, are you able to get to the roof without a ladder? He said, no, you need a ladder. He said, okay, we never leave at the time of Muhammad. Name your man to us. Who is your man? Who is your narrators? And not just say, name your man, deep investigation. Our investigation hadith is more powerful than the FBI investigation. To make that clear to you. You know what I'm saying? So deep, so precise that even we test people that narrate hadith. Like the time Prophet, the time Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal, who was a man narrating hadith from Sufyan al-Thawri. Okay? Sufyan al-Thawri, one of the Muslim scholars of the Salaf. So people start thinking, how can we be sure that this man met Sufyan al-Thawri? So they came to Ahmad al-Hanbal and they told him. And Ahmad al-Hanbal said, go ask him if Sufyan al-Thawri is a blind man or not. Just ask him in a way, say, you know Sufyan al-Thawri was a blind man, sahih? Correct? And he said, yeah, he was a blind man. You're kadab, he was not a blind man. They got him, kick him out from Baghdad. Liar, you know what I'm saying? Rather, the Messenger of Allah said, woe to those who make up a hadith to support me and are fabricated. Rather, they deserve their place in the hellfire. Compare this with Paul. Paul said, why you should blame me if my lie increase God's glory? So basically, if I'm lying to make God's glory, why are you gonna blame me? And another one, Paul said, if I go to a Jew, I pretend to be a Jew. Even I don't have no, I'm not a Jew. If I go to an atheist, I pretend, someone without a law, I pretend to be without a law. Even though I'm not, even though I have a law. But guess what? Imagine everyone met him at the same time. The Jew and everyone, what is he gonna do? Stop dancing around? You know what I'm saying? My point here is, wallahi, Islam is a true religion, you like it or not. And you have now fake ex-Muslim coming. You don't know them. Behind the camera, one guy, I left Islam. Why? Because Muhammad fought against enemies and I became a Christian. But hold a minute, Jesus, when he's gonna come back, he's going to kill his enemies. So are you gonna leave Jesus when he come back? Wallahi, you have nothing to stand on. Wallahi, become Muslim before it's too late. Jesus was a Muslim. Khalas then. Jahannam wa bi'sal masir. That's why it's the place. Wallahi, I'm telling you, share food.
But I've learned today and it's good speaking
Alhamdulillah.
To you.
Alhamdulillah. Well, it was my pleasure to talk to you. But I'm warning you, against Jahannam, the hellfire. It's not a joke. قل إن جهنم أشد حرا لو كانوا يفقهون فليضحكوا قليلا وليبكوا كثيرا جزاء بما كانوا يكسبون. Allah said the hellfire is worse, hotter. Then let them laugh a little, verily they will cry a lot. Alright, take care.